Smartphones come in various shapes and sizes. The BBC is currently issuing many of its journalists with iPhones. And while much of the following advice applies to those phones specifically, some of the principles apply to other phones too.
Before you start recording, it's best to switch on the airplane mode or divert your calls. If your phone rings, it will stop the recording. The iPhone uses a built-in microphone at the base of the device to record audio.
To get the best recording, hold the phone to the side of your head or slightly under your chin when you're recording voice track or doing interviews. Avoid talking directly into the microphone, as this will distort the quality and create a popping effect.
Think about the environment you are recording in. Outdoors, you could use a windsock attachment. Or alternatively, you could attach a professional microphone to get even better quality audio. This is especially useful when recording interviews. The iPhone uses its Voice Memo app to record audio. To start recording, tap the red button. Tap again to pause the recording, and tap once more to return to it. Tap the word Done to end the recording. You'll then be prompted to give your recording a title. The file will be saved in the Voice Memo Recordings list. To listen back, press the play button.
You can record as much material as you like, but if you share the file via email, you'll be limited to sending 15 minutes of audio as an attachment. More on this in a moment.
The Voice Memo app also lets you read from script notes and record audio at the same time.
In Voice Memo, start recording, then navigate to the notes you need to read. The app will continue recording sound while you read from the notes. When you've finished, return to the Voice Memo app to stop and check the recording.
Most smartphones have similar audio recording apps, so it may be possible for a contributor to record themselves and send a clip to you if you can't get to them in person.
You can share your recording via email, but the audio duration could be no more than 15 minutes using some email accounts. Any recording longer than this will need to be sent in several parts of 15 minutes or less. To shorten your recording, select the item and press Edit. Press the blue icon on the right and move the red bars to mark the in and out points. You can then move the trim handles to refine your edit points. The play button allows you to hear your selection. When you're happy, press Trim and save your clip as a new recording. You can then rename your file. To share your file, click the blue box on the left. You can then email your file directly to the newsroom. BBC journalists can record and file their audio using the internal portable news gathering app, PNG. Using PNG, you can record and send an unlimited amount of audio material straight into the BBC newsroom. There are several apps that BBC journalists are using to edit and make mixed audio packages. They are also broadcasting live audio via the Lucy Live app.
A smartphone has the potential to be a mobile news-gathering device in your pocket. Explore and get comfortable with these techniques, and you'll soon be able to use it to record, edit and share great audio.